Today I will be upgrading this 2009 Mac Pro. I've made videos for the past few years, and this machine has helped me create all of those videos. From creating thumbnails in Photoshop to editing video in Final Cut Pro, this machine has done a wonderful job. I originally received this from a university that was getting rid of it, and when I initially received it, it was in its base configuration. That is mostly the same today. Now, while this machine has served me very admirably, it's in need of some upgrades, and while I could go out and replace this with something newer, I don't really have the budget to do that, so we're just going to upgrade this computer and see how far we can take it. When I originally received this computer, it was in its base configuration. Now, this is the lower tier model that would have been released in 2009. It has a single processor that is a quad-core Intel Xeon running at 2.66 GHz. It originally came with 3 gigabytes of RAM. It originally came with a NVIDIA GT120 graphics card. And it also had a 640 gigabyte standard hard drive. Now, since I originally received it, I've done a couple of very simple upgrades. I've upgraded the RAM to 18 gigabytes just because it's things that I had laying around. The only other thing that I did was I replaced the hard drive with a 250 gigabyte Samsung SSD, which has really improved the performance of the machine. So today we're going to upgrade the processor, the RAM, and the graphics card. Now, the processors in these machines are really limited to quad-core in the 2009 models. However, if you hack the firmware, like I did, the machine will identify as a 2010 Mac Pro and you can run a slew of other processors. But the processor that I went with is this 6-core Intel Xeon that runs at 3.33 GHz. They go for about $40 on eBay, and they perform pretty well. Now, 18 gigabytes of RAM is already plenty for a computer, but we're going to be upgrading it to 20 gigabytes just because I have these two 2-gigabyte modules laying around, which will equate to 20 gigabytes total for this computer. While I'd much rather put a much faster video card in this computer, I had this old GTX 680 laying around from another computer that I had, so I just decided, because it is compatible with macOS High Sierra, that I would just go ahead and use it in this computer. It's a 2-gigabyte card, it's pretty old, but it'll be a huge improvement over the GT120s that are in there right now. And of course, replacing the processor means you're going to need some thermal compound paste to put on the processor. This goes in between the heatsink and the processor. Now, upgrading these computers is incredibly easy. You just flip a switch like you saw there and the cover comes off. We're going to start with upgrading the processor, which is in that bottom compartment there with the RAM. To get at the processor, there is these little levers that you have to bring out. And then once you bring those out, you'll be able to pull this whole tray forward. Now, the processors sit on a separate tray, and that whole tray needs to be removed from the computer, as you're going to see here. It still amazes me just how well-crafted these computers are and, you know, just how strong they are. So as you can see, the processor tray just kind of comes right out from the rest of the computer. All right, so once you have the tray pulled out, you're going to want to set the rest of the computer aside and begin to loosen the Allen screws, which are spring-loaded, that hold the heatsink to the processor. That's this big gray tower. Now, there are five of these. Like I said, they're spring-loaded, so you don't have to worry about them coming out or anything, but it does take a little bit of time to get them all loosened and to remove the heatsink. Just a little side note here, you are going to need an extra long Allen wrench to get these screws out because of the heatsink's depth. So you're going to need to purchase a longer Allen wrench. And once all of the screws are removed, you can carefully lift the heatsink. Now, it might give a little bit of resistance because there is a connector that connects the fan in the heatsink up to the logic board. So you can just remove the heatsink. This would be a good time to go ahead and clean any built-up dust that is in the computer. As you can see, we're going to take the camera in here. You can see all the dust that's kind of built up on the board. You're just going to want to remove that now. And something I found is that a paintbrush is very effective at removing all of the dust. So now we're going to want to remove the old processor. You just push down on this little retention arm, this little trap door comes up, and you can actually remove the old processor from the socket. And just as the old processor was removed, the new one can just be set in place. Now you're going to want to make sure that the top of the processor is very clean, so just taking some rubbing alcohol and a Q-tip, you're going to want to make sure that's clean. Likewise, you're going to want to take the heat sink and clean the copper pad on the bottom. You can use the same method that you use to clean the top of the processor. You're just going to remove all the old thermal paste that's kind of built up there so that we can apply some new thermal paste. Using the new thermal paste, just put like a pea-sized dot of it on top of the processor, and then you can go ahead and take the heatsink, place it on top, and begin to tighten the screws. This will kind of spread the thermal paste over top of the processor, and you should be good to go with the thermal paste. Once you have all of the screws tightened, you're good to go with the processor, and we're going to move on to the RAM. This is by far the easiest thing to upgrade. Now, as you can see, I have 2 8-gigabyte modules in the first two channels there, so we're just going to remove these other 2 1-gigabyte modules and replace them with these 2-gigabyte modules. They just kind of clip in place, you push them down, and you're good to go. It's like installing, you know, a game cartridge. It's very easy. Once you have your RAM installed, it's very easy to put the processor tray just back the way that it came. You just kind of slide it in into where the processor tray goes, and then you push the two little levers and it'll just snap right back in place. The next thing we're going to do is upgrade the video card. Now, something you have to keep in mind is if you're not using an official AMD Apple supported video card, you're going to need to use some drivers to get the graphics card to work. These things are called the NVIDIA web drivers. You're going to need to install these before you upgrade the video card. And once you have these installed, they will allow you to run NVIDIA graphics cards from the 900 series and older. In this case, I'm going to be putting a GTX 680 in here, so these are going to work with the web drivers. Once you have that taken care of, it's time to remove your old cards. The fan has a little button on it that you're going to push, and you're going to want to slide it out, as you saw right there. Once you have the fan slid out, which unlocks the cards, you're going to want to undo these little thumb screws that hold in this plate. This little plate comes off, and then you can then kind of grab onto the card and pull it out, and you can remove your old cards. Once you get your old cards removed, you're just going to snap in the mini 6-pin cords to the mini 6-pin connectors on the board. Before you install your card, you might need to remove a little back plate that allows it to rest in place. You can also reposition this back plate if you need to fill an empty hole left over from, say, an old card. And then in order to install the card, you just line it up on the board and slide it in. It's pretty easy. Once you have the graphics card slid in, you're going to want to hook up these power cords to the header on the card, and then obviously slide the fan lock back in and screw back in that thumb plate. And with that, our upgrades are complete. Time to see how we did. Yes! Now that it's working, I figured I'd run some tests before and after the upgrades to see how my performance increase was. In Geekbench, before the upgrades, the score for the processor was 492 for the single-core score, and the multi-core score was 1837. After the upgrades, my single-core score went up significantly to 660, and my multi-score pretty much doubled to 3,383, which is a pretty significant increase. For a graphics test, I decided to run Unigine Heaven at the medium preset, and this is it exactly how it was on the old graphics card. As you can see, it was running at about 7 to 8 frames per second, so pretty choppy and overall pretty bad quality. After the upgrades, you can see a pretty significant increase in the frame rate. This is at the same preset with the GTX 680, and you can see it's much smoother We were getting frame rates about 50 to 60, which is just a massive increase. So the graphics performance has really gone up even more than the processing performance. Overall, these upgrades were well worth the money. And to be honest, I had a lot of these parts lying around. Really, I only needed the processor, those graphics card cables, and the thermal paste. The upgrades altogether cost me about $60. And I expect that I will get several more years out of this machine. It's crazy that it's 12 years old and it's still able to edit video, edit photo, and it still works perfectly fine. Now, while exporting times are a little longer, that's okay. And performance in Final Cut Pro is pretty incredible. I'm actually editing this video right now in Final Cut Pro. I love this computer. It didn't owe me anything. I got it for free, and yet it's been a wonderful device. So thank you for watching, and long live the Mac Pro.